Hi and welcome to another episode of PeaceMeg TV. In today's Reaper tutorial, we're going to be taking a look at how we can work with effects chains. We're going to take a look at how we can create an effects chain and we can save that out and call that up as a group of effects all linked together on any other track. We'll also look at how we can specify that we want every new track we create to have this effects chain installed or loaded in as default every time we create a new one. So let's take a look at how this all works. So if I come to this particular track and open up the effects panel, you can see that I've got a couple of effects on there. I've got a limiter, an instance of Easy Mix, and I've got a re-EQ on there. Now what I could do if I wanted to, I could select all these, I could right click and I can say copy all effects, minimize that, go to my new track, click, right click, and say paste effects, and all of those effects will be pasted in there, but that's just a little bit long-winded. So let's take a look at how we can do that easier. So we'll go back into the effects browser, the effects panel, and we'll see we've got these three effects. So I'm going to just right click and I'm going to select effects chains, and I'm going to say save all effects as chain. So if I click on that, or I do Control and S, that will bring up the ability to save these out as an effects chain. So you can see I've got one I've previously created, and what I'll do is I'll just call this one test bass, as I know it's going to be used on a bass track, and just click save. So we've now saved that as a preset that we can now call up at any time we want. So if I come over to my effects browser, my effects panel, sorry, I can right click and I can just say effects chains, load effects chain, and I can browse for that effects chain, which, okay, it saves us a couple of clicks, but it's not really speeding up our workflow. What I can do is I could just come over any of these empty blocks in the MCP, right click and say add effects chain directly in there, and then I can choose from all the ones that I've saved previously. So test base in this example, and there you can see all of the three effects that we had applied to the first track that we saved out as this preset and now loaded in. Quick and easy, much easier. Okay, now let's just say that I was working on something and every time I created a new track I wanted to apply a certain group of effects to every single track that I created. Then what we can do is, if we come into the effects panel, actually let's just choose one that's got a couple of effects on it. As we saw in the previous one, I can right click over this panel that allows us to select all the different effects we've got in our chain. I can go to the effects chain option and I can say save all effects as default chain for new tracks. So what that will do is every time we create a new track, it will automatically apply all of the filters in this chain to that new track. Now, I'm sure there are instances you'd want to do this if you wanted to put a limiter on every track or an EQ on every track, and then just go in and tweak it afterwards. You could do it this way. For me, it's not the kind of way I work, but it's there if you wanted to use it. So that's a couple of ways that you can speed up the process of working with different effects chains and how you can quickly and easily load those in to either a default track every time you create a new track or to any individual track you want. And you can choose from presets that you've created over time. A great way if you are working on an album, for example, where you're creating something that has the same instruments throughout and you want everything to sound the same across the board, you keep that uniformity. That's a quick way of creating that facility to apply that to every single track that you want on a track by track basis. Well, I hope you found this quick tutorial for Reaper useful. If you have, please hit the subscribe button below to be kept up to date with all of the new videos as they're added to our channel. If you've liked the video, please hit the like button, give it a thumbs up below, it really helps. If you've got any comments, feedback or questions, anything covered in this or anything you'd like to see covered in future videos, please pop that in the comment section below and we'll take a look at creating videos with the questions that you were asking. Until next time, happy mixing.